My name is Justine. I'm a designer working in Silicon Valley. In this video, I'm going to talk about how I interviewed with 23 companies in 2019 and see how you might be able to do the same thing. Good morning, everyone. Happy anniversary. I just passed my 1 year mark working as a full-time designer. So I figured I should take a moment and see how I got there and share with you what I have learned and observed. I was digging through my calendar and emails and I found out I interviewed with 23 companies in 2019. Bigger companies such as Apple, Google, Facebook, Snapchat, Fitbit, Mercedes, Robinhood, DoorDash, 23andMe, Palantir, along with some smaller startups like Niantic, Ubiquiti 6, Homecourt, Lucid Motor, etc. I don't think it's a lot of companies because there are still a handful of those that I couldn't get a chance to chat with. But overall, I think this is a decent list to begin my career with, so I'm thankful for having those opportunities. I want to share a few things that I think helped lead to these interviews, and perhaps you can do the same. Or even get to interview with more companies than I did, more power to you. Number one, simplify your resume. Number two, streamline your portfolio. Number three, smash the apply button. Speaking of smashing, each video took me a lot of time and sweat to make, from writing the script, editing, composing, animating. So if you can scroll down and smash that like button, I will very much appreciate it. Let's dive in. Number one, simplify your resume. You are a UX designer, so you should know, understand the users. And in this case, your users are the readers, the recruiters, and probably the hiring managers for your resume. Simplify and minimize it for the readers. Keep it lightweight. How light? This light. Yes, about a 6-second read. Keep it on one page or even 3/4 of a page. Keeping it minimal so that it's easy for the recruiters to screen. If they can finish in 3 seconds, even better. I would say there are 3 things to highlight and optimize in your resume, so focus on those. The most important thing will be professional work experience, namely internship experiences, for designers like me who just got out of school and look for the first full-time job. The reason being, this is the closest thing to a full-time design job and showcase what you have accomplished or achieved in the past. This is the resume I had back then. 5 internships. MuleSoft, Pinterest, Zynga, Google, Waymo. Not the best one that I've seen, but 2 recruiters, it stood out enough to get me into my first round of phone interviews. For each internship, I had 2 to 3 lines of what I did during the internship, and that's sufficient. If you have 1 or 2 internships, then you can write a little bit more for each, maybe 4 to 5 lines. Just balance out the number of internships and the number of items within an internship on your resume. Next will be your research experience and your publications. Working at a research group in a college or a research institute is also professional experience, especially if you want to get into the field of research, do R&D, or become a researcher. Next will be your education. What school did you go to? What did you do? What did you study? Nothing complicated here. List your specialty in your major if you have one. Baseline. By the time you graduate, you should have a few internships or some research experience, or maybe even a combination of both. Work hard to get more internships while you are still in school so that you can really have a strong resume to begin with to compete with others, and you don't need to worry about jamming in all the trivial information into your resume. Speaking of getting internships, I did a series of how I got my 5 internships and I have different practical tips in each one. You might find them useful. Links up here and also in descriptions down below. Number 2, streamline your portfolio. Similar to a resume, streamline your portfolio for your audience to skim and digest. Because both the recruiters and the hiring managers will and should look at your portfolio after you apply to a job post. A recruiter will most likely look at your resume first, and if they see,
"Oh, this candidate has some interesting and decent internships here and there,"
then they might decide to open up your portfolio link and browse around. The hiring manager, on the other hand, will definitely spend 1 minute or two to click into your portfolio, maybe 1 to 2 projects, and see what you have done in school or in your internships. The common theme here is that both parties will land on the same page, the project catalog page, the one that you have a list of your projects. I'm going to use my portfolio as a reference. I don't think I have the best catalog page, so see what makes sense to you and take what you think is useful. As this is an entry point of any of your projects, I would recommend keeping this page clean, straightforward, easy to understand, very visual, and make it feel simple. That means, number one, leave more white space around each project and give it plenty of room for your audience to breathe. Don't cram the browser so that it feels clean and simple. Number two, each project has a name, a caption of what it is, and its own container, whether it's a list or a grid, so that it's easy to know what that project is and it's straightforward to understand which is which. Number three, have an image of the project to give it a visual reference, to make it more straightforward and more inviting for the recruiters and the hiring managers to click into. I'm using a gallery grid view in my portfolio. You can go with a list view without images. There's no really hard rule here. I have seen some graphic designers that are really good at typography, so their project catalog page is the list of project names and play with typefaces. I wouldn't say I'm a type expert, so I'm not going to go into that direction. And instead, I'm just going to go with my gallery grid view, as that's what I'm more comfortable with. Number three, smash the apply button. Yes, apply to what you can find. It sounds like a lot of work. It is a lot of work, but it's worth it. Plus, an application process nowadays has been much better, much easier, as proper designs are being implemented into the application form. So it's not that bad now, thank the power of design. Applying to everything means you're applying to places that it's my dream job. Places like, maybe. And places like, nah, I don't think so. The reason you want to apply to all is that, one, you want to maximize your exposure as an applicant. If you use any job platforms, LinkedIn, Indeed, whatever, they probably have data showing that you're applying for jobs, you apply for something. And then they might recommend you more to apply to, which means more potential interviews you will get. Two, the more interviews you have, the more practice you will have, meaning the more fluent you will become in your future interviews. If you get an interview with those, nah, I don't think so, companies, you get a chance to practice interviewing with real companies, or perhaps you will get a new understanding of what those companies really are. Then maybe you will level them up, change your mind. Either way, it's a win for you. There's nothing to lose. Three, the reality is that there's no guarantee which company you will get an interview with or an offer from. Sometimes I will get nothing back, sometimes I will get nice messages of not moving on, and sometimes I will get it to the next round. You really don't know. Really don't know. So applying to more gives you a better chance of getting an offer. Four, after you get your first offer, you can leverage that to ask other companies to move faster in your application process or negotiate on the offer itself. Interviews take a lot of time and effort, and there's no other way around it, especially for your first full-time job. You just really have to keep looking and applying. With 23 companies that I interviewed with, I got 3 full-time offers in the end. Having options is great. I was hoping to get 10 and I was aiming for 10. I know before you say it, I know 10 offers might sound a little bit too ambitious and unrealistic, but at least when I aim for 10, I really, really put in the work to push for 10 offers. Even though I only got 3 in the end, I'm still happy with that. Alright guys, that's a quick video about my full-time job hunting experience last year. And the 3 takeaways are, simplify your resume, streamline your portfolio, and smash the apply button. With that said, thank you guys for watching. Hope you find some useful and valuable information in this video. If so, smash that like button for that awesome blue to show up. And if you want to see more videos like this, please subscribe to this channel. This will help motivate me so much in producing more high quality content down the road. Have fun following your passion and keep designing a better future. See you in the next video. Cheers!